Today I am Hardik M. Maru, taking the lecture on engineering physics from Om Engineering College, Junagadh. My designation is assistant professor and I am taking lectures on engineering physics. Friends, today we are going to take a lecture on new topic of magnetic materials. Let us know which type of materials are there, from which there is one material which is magnetic materials. So today we are going to know that which type of materials that magnetic materials are. Let us go to the first slide through which we will try to understand that materials, why do materials are magnetic. After that, we will move towards the application of magnetic materials. Let us move towards the first slide. Our new chapter is of magnetic materials. The materials which can be magnetized are known as magnetic materials. There are various types of materials from which the materials which can be magnetized are known as magnetic materials. Let us move towards the next point. Friends, magnetic materials are the types of materials which can be magnetized. In the same manner, today in this lecture we will know that if the material is magnetic, then why it is magnetic, or what is the reason behind it that these materials behaves as magnet, or magnetic properties are present inside it. In today, the newer applications of these magnetic materials are, you can see or you can observe it on slide. In these applications, we are using magnetic material in our day-to-day uses also. The engineering applications of magnetic materials are electrical machines, second, computers, third, television picture tubes, and fourth, last but not least, it is electronic toys. These are the types of materials, or these are the types of instruments in which, or machines in which magnetic materials are being used. Let us go towards the newer application or the application, best application of magnetic materials. Magnetic materials play an important role in information store as an information storage devices. That means the materials which are magnetic in nature are behaving as the storage devices. They are used to store the memories or datas. That means in the storage devices, the materials which are being used are magnetic. So these are the recent applications of magnetic materials which are providing us the information as a storage devices. Mainly magnetic materials are used in this storage devices. To know whether this material is of which type or whether it is magnetic or not, we should know some basic terms through which you can also know that what is a magnet, or which type of material behaves as a magnet, or in that material which are the basic terms of that magnetic materials. Let us move towards the basic terms and their units through which you can measure the basic terms related to magnetic materials. let us move towards the first term of our magnet. You can observe it in slide. Important terms and units in magnetism. That means magnetic materials are having magnetism. The first term or the first basic term through which you can know the magnet or magnetic material is magnetic poles. The two opposite end of the magnets are known as magnetic poles. As you know or as you studied earlier, in a magnet there are two opposite poles or two opposite ends of the magnets which are known as magnetic poles. The two opposite ends of the magnets are known as magnetic poles. That means North Pole and South Pole, which are present in the magnet, which behaves as magnetic poles. That means we can say that magnet or magnetic material is dipolar. That means it is having one pole and in the same manner it is having the other pole which is opposite to it. In the same manner, if a question arises in our mind that whether the magnetic material or the magnet is having a monopole or not, then I can say that, or as we know earlier, magnets are never having monopoles. That means not single pole is not present on magnet. That means if you cut the magnet from between, then also the magnet doesn't behave as a monopole. Then also it behaves as dipolar and it is having North Pole as well as South Pole. So this was the definition or the first basic term to know the magnet or magnetic material. The two opposite ends of the magnets are known as magnetic poles. Let us move towards the next term. You can see that, or you can observe in the diagram where there is one bar magnet and there are two poles in that. One is North Pole and one is South Pole. And nearby that, you can observe the magnetic field lines which is in the dotted line. The magnetic field lines are emerging from one pole and entering into the another pole, that is from North Pole towards the South Pole. The magnetic field lines describes about the effect of magnetic field nearby the poles. We will also go towards the definition, but first of all you can observe it in your diagram. Now let us move towards the definition. The next definition of or the basic term is pole strength. Let us first of all define the pole strength. Magnetic pole strength of a pole is said to be a unity if it experiences a force of 1 Newton when it is placed at a distance of 1 meter from similar one in air or vacuum. I repeat, magnetic pole strength of a pole is said to be unity if it experiences a force of 1 Newton when it is placed at a distance of 1 meter from a similar one in air or vacuum. That means magnet are having two poles. One is north and another one is south. If we say that if magnetic pole strength of any one pole, suppose say north, then North Pole is said to be unity if it experiences a force of 1 Newton when that North Pole of that magnet is placed at a particular distance of 1 meter and the force experienced by that pole or the North Pole due to another pole which is at the distance of 1 meter away from it, and the force experienced by that North Pole is of 1 Newton in air or vacuum, then that is defined as the pole strength of that magnet. Let us move towards the next basic term through which you can know the basic terms related to magnetic materials. Basic important terms. The next term is the magnetic length. As we described about the poles in the previous definition, there are two poles, that is North Pole and South Pole. Now, if we describe the magnetic length, then magnetic length can be defined as the distance between two poles is known as magnetic length. That means magnet is dipolar, and in the same manner, the distance between two poles in that magnet are known as magnetic length. As we move forward, we can observe the definition of magnetic field. And to describe that, I should go on that slide. Let us observe that slide. Magnetic field can be defined as the region where magnetic field can be defined as the region where the effects of magnet or magnetism can be experienced is defined as the magnetic field. I repeat, the region where a magnetic pole experiences a force is defined as the magnetic field. In the same manner, if we define magnetic field, it can be in this manner also. The effects of magnetic field near the poles of a magnet is known as magnetic field. That means force experienced by any pole of a magnet is defined as the magnetic field. That means in the nearby area of the poles, if another magnet or magnetic pole is nearby and if experiences a forces, then it is due to the magnetic field. So this was the definition of magnetic length as well as the definition of magnetic field. Let us move towards the next definition of the basic terms of magnetic materials. Here you can see the magnetic lines of forces. As we defined the magnetic field, you can observe it in the diagram that there is one magnet, or there are various magnets or bar magnets, from which you can observe in the diagram that the magnetic field lines in the dotted line are shown in the figure. You can see that in the upper diagram that one magnet is facing the another magnet with two opposite poles. That means one magnet is having the north pole in front of the another magnet's south pole. That means unlike poles attracts. You can observe there. That means from north pole the magnetic field lines are emerging out, and that magnetic field lines are entering back into the south pole. That means these poles are following a loop or making a loop, and that means the two opposite unlike poles attract each other, and these are the lines of forces due to the magnetic field lines. Now in the same manner, if we talk about like poles, then like poles repel each other. That means the magnetic field lines is emerging out from the north pole of one magnet, and in the same manner the opposing magnet having the north pole, they both magnetic field lines repel each other. And in the same manner, if we talk about the next slide, we have one next basic term. Let us move towards the basic term magnetic field lines or magnetic lines of forces. These are some of the points which describes about the magnetic lines of forces. The magnetic lines of forces are continuous and form complete loop. As we observed in the diagram, the magnetic field lines are continuous and form complete loop. They are not breaking. Second point, never cross each other. That means magnetic field lines never crosses each other. Third point, it causes like poles, that is north north and south south, to repel each other and cause unlike pulses, that is north south or south north, to attract each other. And this north north and south south repel each other, and in the same manner unlike poles like north and south attract each other, which means that this effect is created due to the magnetic lines of forces. The fifth point is parallel line joining in the same direction repel each other. I repeat, parallel line joining in the same direction repel each other. So these are some of the points which describes about magnetic line of forces. Now let us move towards the next basic term. These are the magnetic lines of forces. The magnetic field is assumed to consist of lines of magnetic forces. These lines of magnetic forces to proceed from North Pole and passes through the surrounding medium and then re-enters into the South Pole, as we observed it in diagram. The next definition is related to magnetic flux density, or it can be described as magnetic induction. I repeat, magnetic flux density or magnetic induction. The symbol of magnetic flux density is B. The magnetic induction or magnetic flux density is defined as the magnetic flux F passing normally through an unit area of cross section at that point. You can observe the equation in the slide that B is the magnetic flux density, which is equal to 5. This 5 represents the magnetic flux lines or magnetic flux. 5 represents the magnetic flux.